Okay, so lagi sa ato folder sa timeline is maganda sa ito. Maganda na ang nagbago mabuo kung sa kagalan pa. Hindi kaya kaya tumabuo. So maganda ang timeline is maraming salamat po sa mga wheelchair sa T5 na pinadala ng noong unang imanitaya namin sa Tawang Kalero. Ngayon, pangalawang optical mission na namin ngayon dito sa Carmel. Ang suwerte ninyo, pangalawang kayong beneficiary sa ating mega humanitaya. To our to all the representatives of Francis Leo Michael, Mr. Jesus Batalan, Sir, President of the Philippine Economic Club, Mr. Corporate and Worldwide, to all our esteemed doctors attended by the Foreign Grace of God, to our FSTI guests, and to everyone present here for this memorable occasion, I welcome you to present the Feminist Grants Foundation second humanitarian event here at the Municipality of Carmel, the home of the largest safari and adventure park in Cebu. As the founder of the Feminist Grants Foundation, please allow me to tell you a little about us and how we started. In year 2001, I established Luz Cabacingan Foundation, Nanay Ayan, in memory of my late loving mother, Nanay Luz, na naging inspiration ko sa maging mapagbigay at maawain sa kapwa. Back then, using my own funds, I was dedicated to provide college scholarship grants sa mga mahihirap at well-deserved students. Kasi, naiintindihan ko at napagdaanan ko ang hirap na gusto mo makapag-aral pero wala kayong sapat na pera. Unfortunately, the Luz Cabacingan Foundation was put on hold kasi nagpatayo ako ng sarili school and I remain focused on administering the school. But despite that, kahit pakunti-kunti, hindi na wala sa akin ang pagtulong. I started to have year-to-year programs in my hometown of Batanan, Iloan, Cebu, and to the abundant children with disabilities. After Uganda in 2013, I was one of those who responded to the relief groups to the typhoon victims in Pampayan Island. I continue to provide solid scholarships. I also give cash assistance to those patients with cancer and any other form of sickness. I financially support the congregation of Salesian Madonna Moscow Top Province and many more. It was really fulfilling on my part to be of help to those who were in need. Para ang gandaan sa loob na makita na sila na sa kunting tulong mo na isang ang mga problema nila. But through the years, I felt like I wanted to do more, pero hindi ko alam kung ano. Biglang tumali sa isipan ko na I want to revive the youth sa Batingan Foundation, pero hindi ko alam kung paano ko siya sumagan ulit. Then I prayed the Lord for the guidance of the Holy Father, Almighty and of course, with the intercession of Mama Mary, Our Lady of Lords. And I held on to the belief that there will always be a perfect time for everything. So, I patiently waited for my time. Noong nag-lockdown in 2020, we were all in our homes and we were busy finding sanity because most of us were not used to being placed on lockdown. So, like most of you, I spent my free time watching YouTube. Nakita ko si Francis Leo Margot, also known as SLM, nag-viral sa YouTube. I followed him kasi nagkaroon siya ng mayaman challenge. At tinanggap ko naman ang challenge na yun. Ito na siguro ang pinakamalapit sa lahat ng nagawa ko ng humanitarian. I was able to help 34 barangays in Cebu City na magdali ako ng ligtas and raise of eggs to more than 100 Family Square Barangay.
Yes.
Ubusan, sinugan talaga ng pera. Pero masaya ako na marami akong natulungan, lalo na at maraming nawalan ng trabaho during the pandemic. Dahil hindi ko naman kaya mabigyan lahat, I tried to reach out to FLM at nakiusap ako sa kanya na sana makaabutin ang tulong niya sa mga Cebuano. I told him I had a foundation and I was planning to invite it. Sabi niya, kung willing na talaga mag-focus sa humanitarian, may kailangan kang i-give up because you gonna serve two masters at the same time. Sabi niya, mabalikan ko siya kapag nakalikay na ako. Not that the woman that I am is busy making a living kasi naging busy din ako sa real estate business. But to cut the story short, I gave up real estate business and I had made up my mind and followed my heart's desire, which is to do charitable work. Nakiusap ulit ako kay Francis Leo na sana matulungan niya ako sa bagong organization na ito, na nga, ito na nga ang Charity Esperanza, which means Seeds of Hope. Maraming salamat, Francis, sa malaki at walang sawang pagtulong mo sa mga mahihirap. Ikaw ang naging daan para magawa namin ang medyo humanitarian na ito. Sabi mo nga, manalo man o matalo sa pagkasimador, tuloy ang pagtulong ko sa mga Papa, my big thanks to Dr. Rascal and to her fellow doctors for their invaluable services. To FFPIP headed by Sir Dong Matalan for your time and effort in coming over just to face this event. To our special Therefore, to the people who are behind this huge event, to Mayor Carlo Villamor and Vice Mayor Gerard Villamor for their warm welcome and support to this undertaking. To the Executive Director, Mr. Emilio Batas, and the whole group of Family Esperanza Foundation. To the local government units, from the officials, health workers, police departments, volunteers, Mago Deputies, and of course, to Ma'am Mary Sandler, fully supported the cause and sponsor of the AOM Marcos. Our coordinator is in Carmen. Siya po ang contact namin dito para makapunta kami dito. Sa lahat ng sponsors, and to everyone who extended their support to make this event possible and success. Many, many thanks to all of you. Now, we are now second legal humanitarian optical mission. Sana sa susunod na humanitarian, andyan pa rin kayo. Ang sumar dito, Sonsobo naman. August 13, Sonsobo po kami. I firmly believe in God's perfect timing. I can say that it is the right time for my life in the world. As I end my message, I would like to share with you this passage in Luke chapter 1, verse 37. Nothing is impossible with God. To God be the glory.
All right, susunod yata magsasalita ay si President Dong ng FFCI World War.
Ang sumunod, patapos na din sa video, nalangin na may video ay pakita ninyo sa pinupataka super design. Okay, please focus your attention to screen.
However, deep in my heart, I don't want to be a politician. That is not my culture. No, that is not my business. I just wanted to know everyone as much as possible. The Ilocanos, the Bulaqueños, the Magalog, the Visayans, and the Mindanaoan. Of course, it's even so long. Regardless of praise, the guidance of power. Everybody must help one another. Filipinos are like that. And always wanted to live by each other happiness. We do not want to live by each other misery. We do not hate and despise one another. In our country, there is a place for everyone. And the beautiful world is bounded in peace and can provide for everyone. The role of life can be as liberty and poverty, but many of our brothers and sisters have lost their way. Greediness to fame, power, and wealth have poisoned our souls. Those ambitious men fight with the world we live, and foolish individuals broadcast. Understanding and wisdom. We have the country, but we almost lost humanity. Our knowledge has made us cynical. Our cleverness has made us skeptical. We strive for the land, and now we live in them. We need a new mighty modern technology. We need kindness and gentleness, better than cleverness. The absence of these qualities in the heart of man, life will be suddenly and all will be lost. The very essence of this lesson is all of you is to find out what the righteousness in man and appeal for universal brotherhood, for the unity of all people. Those who can hear me, I say, do not distress. The hardship in life is not about how they should be comfortable. According to St. Luke, the kingdom of God is in the heart of man, not just one, ten, or 100 men, but in all men, all of you. I am just an ordinary man who finds to awaken the kingdom of heaven in his mind. The right means that we are all kings. The hero that has the power to save happiness. The hero that has the power to make his life beautiful and lovely. Then in the name of liberty and democracy, let us use the revolution within us to create a different world that will give all of us equal rights and equal opportunity. A world that can provide a better future for our children and the security to our safer community. And I'm happy for
okay, so daghang salamat sa pagtanaw ninyo sa ato ang program niyo. Sunod ang tawagon ng atong Executive Director sa Humanitarian Foundation, si Mr. Nino Batag, na sa huliya ang isang plaque of appreciation sa inatag nato sa Fernando de Lora Pangan, si Pamaria Santa, inatag ang plaque of appreciation sa iyang secretary na si Sir Joel Bacalan. Sir Lidio, Sir Lidio.
All right, this program is brought to you by Kuya Ferdinand Boardi from Cavite. Super Sticker. Thank you so much.
I like it. So we are giving this plan of appreciation from Celine Sri Lanka Foundation Incorporated, presented to Manuel Galiana Pangan,
okay, so
for your continuous sponsorship and support to Celine Sri Lanka Foundation Incorporated. Your generosity is instrument in making a difference in the lives of men. Given this 23rd of July 2022 at Farmer Sports Complex, Municipality of Farmer Cebu, Philippines. Signed, Pilipita Kabatingan, Founder.
Binigyan ng parangal ang FFCI galing sa Cemetery Esperanza, nagbigay ng plaque. Ayan. Nakikita po natin mga kapatid ang mga tao na mabibigyan ng pagkakataon luminaw ang mata. Ayan. Ito naman yung mga recipient ng ating mga wheelchair. Mga bago yan mga kapatid. No? Ando, nabigay na sa kanila yung kanilang mga wheelchair. At si President Dong naman ay magsasalita. Ano po yun eh?
At sa ating atag nato. At sa
may ano si nanay? Mayroong pamchilit? So yun yung mga pamchilit? Hindi ko nababasa yung mga comments nyo ah. Wait lang. So ganito karami, nakikita niyo mga kapatid, no? Ganito po karami ang tao rito ngayon sa open court.
And I'm going to go to the next one.